Hi everyone, myself Khushi Banerjee from Asansol Engineering College. Today we will study about the Crossbar matrix. Now in earlier days, Strouger was used. What was the disadvantage of Strouger? That it consists of various electromechanical parts. So that electromechanical parts causes heat as well as wear and tear of the instrument. So maintenance cost was higher. So to replace that, crossbar came into existence. First we will study about the 3x3 crossbar matrix. Now it consists of 3 activators on this side and 3 activators ABC on this side. So in total, how many number of contact points we will get? 3 into 3, that is N into M. In this case, we have 3 into 3, so total 9 activators, 9 contact points will be present. While the total number of activators will be N plus M, that is 6 activators will be here. Now in the diagram, we can see it consists of some solid lines as well as some dotted lines. Now what are these solid lines denoting? These solid lines are denoting the wires. This is the horizontal solid line, this one is the vertical solid line. So these are denoting the wire. Similarly, this one B, B. This one C, horizontal and vertical C. So these are denoting the wires. While the dotted lines are denoting the bars present. So here we can see that these dotted lines are connecting to the bars. Now further, these bars are connected to the electromagnets M1 dash, M2 dash, M3 dash. Similarly, on this side also, the dotted lines are connected to the electromagnets M1, M2, M3. So these are the vertical dotted lines, vertical bars, which are connected to the electromagnets M1 dash, M2 dash, M3 dash. And these are the horizontal bars, which are connected to the electromagnets M1, M2 and M3. Now how is the working happening? Now let us suppose this subscriber B wants to talk with subscriber C. So which contact point will be utilized? We can see there are 9 contact points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So in total there are 9 contact points. For subscriber B to communicate with subscriber C, this contact point 6 will be utilized. But we can see that there is a gap present between the 2 contact points. So this contact point is connected to the horizontal line B and this contact point is connected to the vertical line C. In between we can see that there is a gap present. Now when the conversation begins between the two subscribers B and C, the two contact points need to come close to each other so that electrical path is established and the communication begins between the subscriber B and subscriber C. So how this happens? That is how the two contact points come close to each other so that there will be electrical path established between the two. The working is like this. Now these bars are connected to the electromagnets M2 and M3 dash. Now first the horizontal electromagnet will be magnetized. For the contact point 6, the horizontal electromagnet is M2 while the vertical electromagnet is M3 dash. So first the horizontal magnet M2 will be magnetized. So what will happen? This is connected to this contact point. This contact point will move closer to upper side. Then the vertical electromagnet M3 will be magnetized. So what will happen? This contact point will move closer to this contact point. So ultimately these two contact points will come close to each other and the continuous electrical path will be established like this. From B to this contact point, then to this contact point and then further to C. So the conversation between the subscriber B and C begins. So these are the various steps. Now this we can see in this also, that is N into M is the total set of contact points. Here the total number of contact points will be what? 3 into 3, that is total 9 contact points will be present. Number of activators will be 3 plus 3, that is 6 activators will be required. Contact points are mechanically mounted and electrically isolated on vertical and horizontal bars as shown in the dotted line. This we can see from this diagram, that is these contact points are mechanically mounted on the wires but these are electrically isolated. So when they will come contact with each other, when the electromagnet will be magnetized, these two contact points will come closer to each other. Otherwise they are mechanically mounted while electrically isolated. While the next point is how the path will be established. First step is electromagnet, say the horizontal direction is energized, the bar attached to it slightly rotates. So what is the first step? The first step is horizontal electromagnet will be magnetized. So the contact point will rotate in this direction. What is the next step? The vertical electromagnet is energized, due to which the bar rotates, the contact point at the intersection of the two bars come close to each other. First, the horizontal will be energized, and then the vertical will be energized. So then vertical electromagnet, that is in this case M3 dash, will be energized, due to which this contact point move closer to this point. So ultimately a contact will be formed at this two point. For conversation of B and this C, 6 is required. For this, the electromagnet horizontal M2 will be first magnetized, and then the vertical electromagnet M3 dash will be magnetized. So ultimately these two contact points come close to each other, and the continuous electrical path will be established, and the conversation between the two subscribers start. So what is the last step? If electromagnet M2 and M3 dash are energized, a contact point is established at cross point number 6, such that subscriber B is connected to the subscriber number C. Thank you.